leaps and bounds, these daring, agile youngsters made their way around town. One person taking part in this rally in Rome was Lorenzo Castello, who was 14 at the time. He's now 23 and still chooses unusual routes to get from A to B. You have to be courageous and fit to do parkour. Lorenzo trains with Abdallah Inshasi. Maria Serena Mignani, Lorenzo's mother, has made a film about the fascination of parkour.
As a parent, I started wondering if it was right to suppress this, or if it would be better to indulge his natural inclination. When we discovered parkour by chance, we saw some boys jumping. We were completely bowled over by this vortex. And I started feeling the need to consider not just the risky and spectacular side of this discipline, but also the values behind it.
Even in primary school, Lorenzo found new ways to get around, often surprising his teachers.
Buongiorno, chiamo dalla segreteria della scuola.
Oddio, è successo qualcosa?
No, niente di grave, non si agiti. Solo che ancora una volta Lorenzo è entrato e uscito dalla finestra e insomma... I maestri sono un po' preoccupati.
Sì, sì.
L'altro giorno una maestra l'ha visto saltare dalla rampa del primo piano.
Ho iniziato a fare parkour per...
I started practicing parkour to unwind.
Quando ero piccolino stavo per sei ore in classe.
When I was little, I had to sit for six hours in class and it didn't work for me. I need to go out to run and jump. Parkour gave me the means to fulfill this physical need that would otherwise be suppressed.
For Lorenzo, parkour is more than a competitive sport, it's a learning experience.
Parkour taught me that when you meet an obstacle, one option is to go around it.
Sì, ci può girare attorno, ma
but if you jump over it, maybe you'll land further away.
Di quanto non potrebbe fare girandoci attorno. E diciamo,
this is what I worked out physically when I was younger.
Fisicamente quando ero più piccolo, eccetera.
As I grew up,
poi, man mano crescendo,
I realized that it is an attitude you can adopt towards every kind of obstacle that life puts in your way.
Tutti i tipi di ostacoli che incontri nella vita.
Abdallah Inshasi, Lorenzo's friend and trainer, is from Palestine. He grew up in the Gaza Strip. Parkour helped him cope with life there.
The most dangerous thing about living inside Gaza is kill your dream and your hopes. But when you do parkour, you have things to do it. You have a chance.
For Lorenzo's mother, Maria Serena Mignani, making a film about parkour was a journey of discovery.
At
some point, I started wishing that this ability to turn every obstacle into a creative opportunity could be transferred from the physical realm to my mental approach, my approach to everyday life. I saw many young men use it as life training. I can say that in my life, even if I have not jumped over obstacles, I've done a lot of mental parkour.